As the president toured a farm in Northfield, hundreds came together in Minneapolis to protest Biden's stance on Israel's retaliation against Hamas in Gaza. Morgan Wolf has a look at how the war is fueling a deep divide here at home.
Freedom for Palestine! Freedom for Palestine!
Fighting over 6,000 miles away. Is hitting home for Minnesotans.
This has claimed the life of over 8,000 Palestinians and over 3,500 children in just 3 weeks.
Sana Waswa says that the pain and suffering of Palestinians in Gaza is palpable.
Even when Palestinians protest nonviolently, when they're engaging in actions that have nothing to do with Hamas, we still see the aggression leverage against them.
People tonight coming together calling for President Biden to stop supporting Israel as the country retaliates against Hamas with attacks from the air and on the ground. This all started 3 weeks ago when Hamas launched an unexpected assault on Israel, killing more than 1,000 Israelis.
Bloodiest day in Jewish history since the Holocaust.
But this conflict has a long history.
It goes back to the centrality of the Holy Land.
The Jewish Community Relations Council of Minnesota and the Dakotas points to the handful of attempts to gain peace with Palestine.
You know, there's so much, unfortunately, to correct on the record, so many misapprehensions and mistaken facts and the like.
Shut it down!
Bloodshed on both sides, shining a light on one fact, immense hurt for both Palestinians and Israelis.
Ceasefire right now would be disastrous for Israel, given the fact that it would essentially immunize Hamas for having crossed the border and committed horrible atrocities and taken hostages. If Israel can't exercise its absolute right to self-defense within the laws of war.
I believe that the Palestinian civilians of Gaza should not be punished for the actions of one political group.
Demonstrators marched towards where the president was having a campaign event tonight. All protests throughout the day remained peaceful.
All right, thank you, Morgan. The president appears to be losing support from a coalition of Muslim voters. Today, a group of Muslim community leaders launched a campaign called Abandon Biden, promising at least 50,000 Muslim Minnesotans will not vote for Biden in next year's election. Biden did not mention the protests during his appearances today.